First of all, I will import the data from the Excel file. I use this code to import the data from the history log Excel. And I use a directory I need to save. This notebook file to specify the location of the notebook, and it can then I can use the notebook directory function to return the URL of this notebook file and join with the history log the Excel. After import, I will show you. This is the table form of data that I import from the history log Excel. Then I add it to the manipulate, and I want to show. I use variable data in the manipulator, so I need to declare the data. You can see the table of the data that I import from the history log Excel. If you need to show the text, you can use the text function. But there is a problem that the manipulator can show only one content. If you use the code like this, you can show only the grid of the data. If you need to show more data, you can use row or column to add more the content in the manipulator. So I will show two things. That is the first one is the text, and the second is the grid of the data. I use style to change the text literally from normal text to the pattern format. You can use row or column, so I think I need to to show two objects in the vertical alignment. So I need to change to the column function. You can see that the text will be shown like this. Then I need to create the demand input field. You can see that the demand control will be shown in the right side of the screen. And I need to change the control placement to the top. You can change the control placement by using this code control placement, and you can indicate the position that you need to put the control. I will show the value of the demand that I enter in the input field. You can see that when I input the 25 in the input field, the output will be changed. The output in the manipulator will be changed from 0 to 25. Then I need to create the button. Are you sharing the button? Are you add the button for to the manipulate by use this code? I declare the button variable. I will declare to for sometime I need to return the value it to the button variable and use it later, or you can just declare and not use. It's okay, but the important thing that is the button function. For the action of button, I will multiply demand by 2. Then if I enter the demand 30, the demand will be 30 in the screen of the manipulator, and if I press F, it will be 60. And you can see that the variable of demand that by with the input field here is 60. Will be changed after you press F. And the output of the manipulation will be changed too, because in the input field and the text will be binding with the demand variable. If you have many functions, when you press button, you can use semicolon to take more action. The first action when I press the button, I double the demand value and then export the file. Okay, I will input 20 and then press F. I enter 20 and then press F. and then I will show you that the test Excel will be exported to my export to the Excel file. And you can see that the data will be shown when I import the test Excel. So you can declare the variable here. Declare variable to buy the control, buy the control in the manipulator, and then use the declare variable in the presentation part of the manipulation. I will use the pop-up menu to be the control of the product input. I will declare the product variable. The product variable in the first parameter is the detail of the variable, that is the variable name, initial value, and the alias name that will shown in the control part of the manipulation. And the second parameter is the detail of the variable, that is when you select passage, the product will be 1. When you select ham, the product will be 2. This is the first the value the key the first item the key of the first item is one. The one is the value of the variable. The value that is assigned to the variable, and the value is to show the user to, for selecting. For example, one will be represent for sausage, and the manipulation will show the sausage, the word sausage to the user. And when you select sausage, it means that the variable product will be one. I will change. I add the another text product. You can see that the pop-up menu is show the sausage. The product will be one, and then I select ham. It will be two. And then I need to show the data that I select from the pop-up menu. Then I add the another variable I need to declare into the function type. Then I function type. Previously I taught you how to select the data from the select function. Then I show you in this example too. I select the data and the product ID is in the second column. Then I give the condition for the for selecting the data by the value of the column two of the list data is equal to product. Don't forget to hide the ampersand. After the condition, it will be applied to the select function. And then I change it to the set data. You can see the result of the manipulation. The default of the product is one, so the data of the sausage will be shown. And if I change to ham, it will be shown the data of ham. If I add another item, it's bacon. You can see that the value will be changed. You can add row inside the column, or you can add column inside the row. When you combine column and row function, it can create the table in the manipulation. You can see how the result is changed, the demand and the product will be changed. Previously the demand and product will align in the vertical, and then it will align with the horizontal. You can add the panel to add the border of the text. That's all that these are the code that I use to implement the inventory management that I showed you previously. Which function do you need to know? You can tell me. Any questions?